Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, I'm going to provide you with a high-level overview of financial statement preparation. We'll start off by answering the question to, what are financial statements? Next, we'll get an understanding of the purpose behind each of the principal financial statements and why they're so important to users. Finally, we'll go through the flow of the financial statement preparation process using specific examples. Whether you're looking to be a manager in a business, start your own company, or even become an investor, a general understanding of the financial statement preparation process will give you the tools you need to be successful. So let's jump in. Most companies spend a significant amount of time and resources preparing their financial statements. But why is this such an important process? This is because accounting is the language of business. And just like any other language, we need a way to efficiently communicate information about a company's performance to the stakeholders. Financial statements are the key mechanism that allow companies to do this. But before we get into how the financial statements are prepared, let's get an understanding of the purpose behind each financial statement. Now, companies have a variety of stakeholders that are very interested in their financial performance, including creditors, investors, customers, and the government. These users of the financial statements need an efficient way to gather key insights about the company's performance. The majority of companies prepare standard financial statements each period following a set of accounting rules. So let's run through a high-level overview of each financial statement, starting with the balance sheet. You can think of the balance sheet as a snapshot of a moment in time that gives us an overview of an organization's financial health, broken down into assets, liabilities, and owner's equity. Assets are the resources the organization owns, such as cash, land, and equipment. Liabilities are debts that the organization has taken on, such as bank loans, wages owed to employees, or debts that are owed to suppliers. The last category is owner's equity, which is the value that remains with the owners, including investment that comes into the company and the earnings generated over time, also known as retained earnings. Now, the value of the company's assets must always equal the value of their liabilities plus owner's equity. This is where the term balance sheet comes from, since it must always remain in balance. In order to keep the lights on, a business must ultimately generate profit. And the income statement is where users can determine how profitable the company was in a particular accounting period. The income statement can be broken down into three components and follows the formula revenue minus expenses equals net income, which is otherwise known as profit. The first section of the income statement keeps track of all the company's revenue, which is the amount earned for selling goods or services. However, it's important to remember that revenue does not equal profit. In order to determine the profitability of a company, we need to take into account all of the operating expenses to keep the business running. Things like rent, utilities, wages, and taxes. The final step is to take all the revenue earned for a period of time, less all the expenses, and hopefully we have something left over at the end of the day, which would be the net income. This net income number feeds into the retained earnings calculation, which ultimately is reported on the balance sheet. More to come on the correlation between the financial statements shortly. Now, while the balance sheet tells us the actual amount of cash sitting in the company, it doesn't tell us exactly where the money came from and where it's being spent. This is where the cash flow statement works its magic by showing us the flow of every dollar, breaking it down into three sections: operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. Now that we have a general understanding of the three principal financial statements, there's a couple of things we want to watch out for. The financial statements don't always tell us the whole story. Now, while the numbers are extremely useful, when evaluating an organization, there are many other useful considerations, such as their reputation for how they treat their employees and their environmental footprint. There's an important relationship between all of the financial statements. This means when it comes to preparing the financial statements, the company must prepare them in a very particular order. If they're prepared in the incorrect order, this could result in significant errors. So let's talk about that order. The first financial statement to be prepared is the income statement. This allows the company to calculate their profitability for a specific period. As you can see, individual accounts are grouped by account type, with revenue listed first, the expense section listed beneath it, and net income or net loss listed at the very bottom. In this example, we can see that ABC Company earned top-line revenue of $90,000 during the month of July. In the expense section below, the goal is to compile all of the company's operational expenses and group them into categories, including some of the ones you're seeing on your screen. Here, we can see a list of the particular company's expenses, totaling $36,000 for July. By subtracting out the total expenses from revenue, less any taxes to be paid, that gives us our final bottom line net profit of $43,200. This profit can either be paid out to shareholders or reinvested in the company. The portion that is reinvested will be added to the company's retained earnings balance. Once that's complete, this allows us to move forward with preparing the balance sheet. Here we see individual accounts are grouped below by account type, with assets listed on the top half and liabilities and owner's equity on the bottom half of the statement. In this example, we can see all of the company's assets are grouped together. Things like the value of their cash, inventory, and property, plant, and equipment. On the bottom half of the balance sheet, the company lists out all their liabilities and owner's equity. For liabilities, companies must report all of their financial commitments. Things like the money they owe their suppliers and debt. For the owner's equity section, the company will report any investment that has come into the organization by shareholders and the cumulative amount of earnings that remain in the company. As you can see here, total assets must always equal total liabilities plus owner's equity. Now that the income statement and balance sheet are complete, we can prepare the statement of cash flows. Here, we work to explain the changes that took place to cash during the period. In this example, we can see that the company had a total change in their cash balance this period of $45,000 across operating, investing, and financing activities. As an example of how this would happen, a company would take note of the changes in their equipment balance during the period by looking at their balance sheet. In the event they bought $25,000 worth of new equipment, this change in cash would get recorded under their investing activities on the statement of cash flows, which can be seen here. This same step would be repeated for each account that impacts cash so that the users have a good understanding of how the company is managing their cash flows. And that brings us to the end of this video. Financial statements provide users with critical information about the company's performance. Whether you're a business owner, employee, or investor, understanding how to read and prepare the financial statements is a critical skill in today's business world. Now, while we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos where we dive even deeper into each of these financial statements.